in, and we're just about set to kick off. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. South Carolina has been waiting all week for this one. Get ready, folks. The opening kickoff is finally here. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 32-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Tackled after a decent pickup.
Gaining 4 yards. That makes it second and six.
It's second down, 6 yards to go. Ball on the 36-yard line. And he throws it away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Around 5 yards on the delayed handoff.
That makes it 4th and 8 inches.
It looks like they're going to go after this punt. The Gamecocks have got a guy at quarterback that is a true leader. We found that out this week talking to him.
We sure did, Brad. It was interesting this week, and as you and I prepared for this game, finding out that he called a players-only meeting without any of the coaches just to get this team focused and let them understand what it takes to go on the road and to win this kind of game. And when you have that kind of leadership, you got a real chance to be able to go on the road and win.
That'll make it second and seven.
From their own 32-yard line. It's second down. Trying to set up a little screen. Gets it to his tailback. Out of bounds at about the 35.
That's some pretty timid play calling right there. Let's see if they decide to open it up a bit more.
Fourth down.
Great hold by the defense. They were expecting the pass play, and they defended it very well.
It's away, and it's a booming punt. And he's taken down at the 29. Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. Tries to get around the corner. Decent run here, right side.
That'll bring up second and three.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Bring him down right around the 44-yard line. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
He's taken down around the 44-yard line. From their own 44-yard line. Second down. And he's tackled at the 43-yard line.
Really good job by the big guys up front to use their size and speed and get the runner in the backfield.
Fly. Can't connect. And that'll make it fourth down.
It was a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
The punting team's got to give their kicker some time. He takes it in at the 14. Brought down at the 26. This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over. And he carries the ball for a nice game. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. The back has it, and he dropped it. Some daylight, and he is drilled at the 42.
They shredded the defense with the option run there. That's a big gain to keep this drive going.
From their own 42-yard line, first down. Just throws this one away. Stop at the 46. From the 46-yard line, it's first down. Fires out to his receiver. Tackle made at the 44-yard line. Complete and taken down immediately. And they'll look to convert here on another third down. Here's the pitch, and now he's got the corner. Tackle right around the 30.
Great job here converting and keeping this defense on the field. They're getting very tired.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. And he's taken down at about the 21. That brings up second and 9. We've played one. Now this one's scoreless. Welcome back. Tight game here in the second quarter as we begin play. The backfield. And this is the 11th play of the current drive. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And down he goes at the 12. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 12-yard line. He scrambles. and they get the sack.
Well, we talked all week with these coaches, and even when we met with them yesterday out at practice, they told us there were some big concerns about facing these defensive ends. They thought that they might be able to hold up against him, maybe get the ball out of the pocket a little bit quicker, maybe use running backs and tight ends to help with double teams on the outside. But right now, whatever they thought they might be able to do, better get back to that drawing board, because these defensive ends are just too quick.
The five. Brought down at the two. That's a deep hit to the ball. That'll make it third and one. So again, a third down as the offense lines up. And they got to him before he could get back to the line.
The defense had that one called perfectly. That's a big play on that loss.
South Carolina is looking to go up by three. The kick is up, and it's good.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 31-yard line. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Tosses left. Good outside run there.
That brings them second and five.
From their own 36-yard line, it's second down. He's out of bounds around the 37-yard line. And down he goes at the 20. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. South Carolina holds a field goal lead. And he throws it away. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 20-yard line. Tries to buy some time. He's tackled at the 31. Gets to about the 34-yard line. From their own 34-yard line. Second down. Gets out to around the 45.
That makes it first and 10.
Slings it out there incomplete.
Number 23, the intended receiver on the play.
Second and 10. Ball on the 45-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. They bring the quarterback down.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
It's third down and 14 yards to go now after that setback by the sack. South Carolina is up a field goal. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. Knocked out of bounds around the 46-yard line.
Great job by the punter of getting the ball inside the 20 and turning over field position for his defense.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Miami just took their first time out from their own 6-yard line. Second down. He's to the 20, and he's hit immediately. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. They'll bring him down at the 33.
I'll tell you what, this defense better start to get pressure on the quarterback. They're giving him way too much time back there to throw the football.
First and 10. Ball on the 33-yard line. Caught with room to work. He's taken down at the 47-yard line. A nice completion to the tight end.
A good play here, and the thing that I notice is that he provides a nice big target out there for the quarterback. Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback, and right now I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 47. He goes downtown. He's got it. He's all the way home. Touchdown.
Wide out here truly knows what he has to do to contribute to make his team successful.
The coverage just couldn't keep up with him there. And he tacks on the extra point. So a 6-play, 99-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
This quarterback has really demonstrated a tremendous amount of ability and leadership today. I'd be very surprised if he didn't continue to play well.
So our score, 7-3. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Immediately tackled. South Carolina's going to take their first time out of the half. It's first and 10. Ball on their own 36. He's hit and taken down. Throws it in a hurry. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
In the shotgun and 5 wideouts. And they got him.
He has one job on passing situations, get to the quarterback. And he did that job very, very well on that play.
It's third down, 12 to go. Ball on the 33. Zips it to the back. That's a great tackle at the 37. It'll be short of the first after the completion.
Well, good effort by the defense to make sure they got him before he got to the marker.
And he's taken down at the 32. Last drive ended with as good a result as you can hope for, and I'm sure they'd like to replicate that here.
Well, I think this defense has got to do something, because right now the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out of it. I would suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with an exotic blitz look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
That makes it second and 10.
From their own 32-yard line, it's second down. One more play now before we hit halftime, so they'll most likely throw one towards the end zone here. He's wrapped up for the sack. We've reached halftime, and we couldn't have asked for a better first half. Miami's up by 4.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Perhaps the most important statistic in any football game is turnover margin. I once had a wise coach tell me that the football was so important they named the game after it. Whatever that means. I think it means that you're not supposed to let it get away from you and give it to the other team. And so far, both of these offenses have done a great job of that.
No doubt. And most games are lost, not won. And it's because of the turnover differential. And you can look at the stats when you say that every single time. But, you know, both teams doing a good job taking care of it. Both offenses executing and still calling a game, still scoring points, still putting up good numbers, but at the same time taking care of the pigskin. And they better value that thing because, yeah, you give it away and bad things happen.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes 3 or 4 axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. Taken from the 3-yard line. And he's hammered down. The Hurricanes continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Gets it out to the tight end, and he can't hang on. From their own 27-yard line, second down. Here's the halfback on the screen. He gets hit out of bounds at the 24-yard line. From their own 24-yard line, it's third down. Quick throw, and he's tackled around the 24-yard line.
That was sort of a funny-looking play. They needed a lot more yards than they got, and yet they settled for a check down, and nothing was there.
They look like they've got the block on, and this offensive line's got to give him some time. To about the 44-yard line. And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Miami is up 4. Rifles this one out to the left. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch. First and 10. Ball on the 34-yard line. And they push him out at the 29-yard line. Throws complete and he stopped immediately. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Check, check, check. the stop at the 14-yard line. Converts the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. He's taken down at the 23-yard line. The defense did a nice job shutting down the offense the last time they had the ball.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
Pass complete and taken down immediately. It's second down, 7 to go. Ball on the 27-yard line. Gets it out quickly. He's pushed out of bounds at the 37-yard line. Around the 39-yard line.
Call it a gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and eight.
From their own 39-yard line, it's second down. They'll drop it for a loss.
You know, these backwards plays can have a psychological impact. It can damage a team's confidence if it keeps happening.
Gets it. He's in space. Brought down at the 49.
I'm not sure if the back was his first option, but he got in the ball, and he was able to make something big happen.
That makes it first and 10.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 49-yard line. Gains his way to the 40-yard line.
That makes it second and 2.
Give to the tailback. And he's taken down at the 41-yard line. Nowhere to go for the halfback. That's a loss of 1. Here's the 8th play of the series. Tackled after decent pickup. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 36. 5 wide.
This quarterback is tough as nails, Brad. He's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
Tackle made around the 22-yard line. This is the 11th play of this drive. At about the 11. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 11-yard line. He's tackled around the 10-yard line. Play 13 of the current drive. Fires incomplete. We played three, and this is not what the experts predicted. 14-3, Miami. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. We're still early in the fourth quarter, but that was a huge stop. And now with the lead, they're going to get the football back and an opportunity to stretch the lead. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. Scrambling around. They'll bring him down right around the 2-yard line. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Makes it out to about the 10. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Good tackle there in space. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 24. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. Makes it out to about the 40.
Did you see how much space there was for that tailback up front? You better be thanking his offensive lineman for that.
First and 10, all on their own 40. Makes it out to about the 49. Just under 3 to go in regulation. He's on the run. Makes it out to about the 26. From the 26-yard line, first down. Gains his way to the 16-yard line. This guy just made those 10 yards look easy. It's the ninth play of the drive. The 5. And he tackles him hard at the 5-yard line.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they look sharp before this one even started.
Taken down at the 8-yard line.
Anytime a running back gets one-on-one with a safety, I think that running back has the confidence in his own athletic ability to be able to make that safety miss and get upfield for some yards. That time, the safety just dominated him, made a great tackle in the backfield for a short loss.
We're at the 12th play of the drive.
Check back
And he's hit before he can go anywhere. Fourth down. This isn't much more than an extra point. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. Kicks up, and he's got it. Miami, ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. The finish line's in sight. Let's see who wants this one more.
Well, now you've got to be thinking end zone on every play. You just don't have the time to do anything else.
I'm sure there are a lot of fans out there hoping for a miracle, but I seriously doubt we're going to see one today. Throws a strike over the middle, and he's tackled right around the 32-yard line.
This is smart, efficient play calling. You don't need to make the highlight reel on each play.
The spike will stop the clock. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. He's going to air it long. Can't make the grab. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. Steps out of bounds at about the 45. It's first and 10. Ball on their own 45. Some stats, so don't be surprised if you see everyone trying to pick this one off. He lets it fly. And he's got the junior. Touchdown, Gamecocks. Only a one-score difference now after that big, big touchdown. He makes the PAT. Oh, what a hit. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ballgame. Miami is up a score. And the quarterback's going to take a knee to drain this clock and any hopes the opposition may have had. And so that's going to do it. The Hurricanes come out on top, 17-10. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.